And welcome everyone to Blaugrana Planet, welcome back to a new video, and today we are going to be reviewing the game between Dinamo de Kiev and Football Club Barcelona, game that ended 0-1 for the Blaugranas in a very crucial game, because if we didn't get the 3 points, our chances in the Champions League were really, really diminished to almost a zero, or only a 4-0 win against Benfica, or a possible win, a draw against Benfica, and a win against Bayern Munich would have been available for us to get to the Champions League round of 16 if we didn't win today. That is why it's so crucial that we got the 3 points today. Although, against Dinamo de Kiev, we normally win 3-0, 5-0. Today, 0-1. And actually, the game in Camp Nou was literally the same. We only scored 2 goals in the Champions League this season, and one of them was by our prince, Ansu Fati. But before I start the review, guys, let me give a special thank you to OneFootball for sponsoring this video and this channel. OneFootball is the best football app, guys. Believe me, it is the best. I've been using it for months, and you can get news, you can get lineups, you can get opinions, you can get everything related to football, and you can download it using my link in the description. And if you do use my link, you're going to be helping to support Blaugrana Planet. So guys, what are you waiting for? Go and download it right now and support Blaugrana Planet, your channel of confidence. The Blaugrana Planet family keeps growing strong, guys. So today, as I said, important game between Dinamo Kiev and Football Club Barcelona. It was the fourth game week of the Champions League this season, and we only got 3 points against the same team. So now we have 6 points in the group, and things are getting better and better. Today, Benfica, by the way, lost against Bayern Munich. This means that we are getting ahead of Benfica, and we're now in second place. Obviously, we need to face Benfica now in Camp Nou in a very crucial game for us, okay? So let's start with the lineups that, the lineups that we faced. These are the lineups, guys. Sergi Barjuan came out with Ter Stegen, Mingueza, Eric Garcia, Lenglet, and Jordi Alba. Let's remember that Piqué was injured, Piqué was out. He got injured in the last game. Frenkie de Jong, Busquets, and Nico González, very prime midfield. At the end of the day, Nico González is getting himself a spot in the starting 11. He's been playing really well, taking into account he's a youngster coming from La Masia. Literally 2 years ago, he was playing for the juvenile team, and now he's a starter in the Champions League. This is Nico González, guys. And on top, we had Gavi, Memphis Depay, and Ansu Fati. We know that Gavi usually starts in the midfield. Today, he started as a false winger, okay? Obviously, he isn't a winger, but he can play in that position as some sort of a false winger, right? And that's exactly what he did. But Gavi doesn't give us that width that, for example, Dembélé did when he came out, okay? So Gavi wasn't giving his best, although Gavi played a really good game, in my opinion. I really like Gavi's game. And overall, obviously, I have to rate Ansu Fati. Although Ansu Fati, in the first half, we didn't see much from Ansu Fati. Certainly in the second we saw more. I like to also give a special mention in a negative way to Frenkie de Jong, okay? Frenkie de Jong sadly has been underperforming lately, guys, and this is the truth. I know for a fact that Xavi is gonna regain Frenkie de Jong's talents, and we're gonna see the best Frenkie de Jong. But for now, guys, Frenkie de Jong is lost in the field. He loses balls. He doesn't recuperate them as much. It's kind of a mess, guys. We need to fix that. Busquets, I think, you know, Busquets is irregular, but when he's good, guys, this guy is critical. And I have a feeling that Xavi will also get the best out of Busquets, and we're gonna see the best version of Busquets under Xavi. I really think so. In terms of the defense, guys, we are very weak in the defense, okay? Whoever plays, we are very weak, okay? You can say Piqué out, Lenglet out, I don't know, whoever you want to leave, but whoever plays, we are very weak. And that is something that deserves a bigger analysis, okay? A deeper analysis. Deeper analysis. I see a Barca that's crossing a lot, guys. Season, two seasons ago, before Koeman arrived, we were the team with the least crosses in La Liga. You know why we do the least crosses? We did the least crosses in La Liga because we can't score a cross, guys. Don't be fooled. We don't score crosses. It's like, it's unreal. We just don't score crosses, okay? It's the way it is. It's just the way it is. And, well, this lineup, I was happy with this lineup then. We saw the substitutions. Araujo came in for Lenglet. He played nothing. He played a bit. Balde came out for Ansu Fati. Well, we couldn't really see anything from Balde. But the big substitution came here, okay? It was Ousmane Dembélé for Gavi. I think this was the key substitution, guys. Why the key substitution? Because Dembélé is electric, guys. What we saw today from Dembélé is the real Dembélé, okay? He's a guy that creates so much disequilibrium, he even disequilibrates himself, okay? It's as simple as that. Like, he even disequilibrates himself. And, well, there was a doubtful here for Ousmane Dembélé. He ended up playing. And guys, like, we have so many players that are doubtful out, you know, well, it's kind of depressing. By the way, I'd like to give a special message to Agüero. I'm sure that he'll recuperate very, very soon. And yeah, guys, so today was a critical game. I feel like Barcelona is showing up lately. We're seeing a better Barcelona, more agile. I can see the Barca DNA now. Under Koeman, we couldn't see anything. It was some sort of a weird mixture. And definitely, Barjuan is not doing anything crazy. He's just applying La Masia templates, you know? And they work. They simply work, you know? And definitely we need, I mean, our squad is it's not as good as it was 2 years ago, 3 years ago. And we don't have goal, guys. The problem is that we can't score, okay? Dembélé doesn't have goal. He has disequilibrium, he doesn't have goal. Luke de Jong, minimal goal. Minimal goal. You can't count this guy for a pure Barca DNA. You can't count the guy. Coutinho, doesn't have goal. Ansu Fati and Depay have goal. These are the only two players that have goal. And Agüero. And Agüero, of course, Agüero had goal, but now Agüero is injured. And, well, yeah, you can't count on the guy for the next 3 months, right? That's the problem. The rumors are that Barcelona are going to be signing a striker in winter. And I don't think that we should do it. And the reason is because I don't want another patch. I don't want another patch. We have Braithwaite there getting back soon. I don't know, soon. Probably by the beginning of next year. So we're going to be for a couple months without Braithwaite. Agüero, 3 months. You have Luke de Jong. But you're going to sign another player now. Who are you going to sign? Who are you going to sign? I don't know. Xavi is going to have to give the consensus here. And I'd rather try to save so in summer we can get a proper signing, you know? Somebody that can last us for the next 5 years or 10 years. That's what I want. That's what I want. Anyways, guys, let me show you what the group looks like right now. This is our group right here. So we are in the second position, 2 points ahead of Benfica. It looks good, guys. Now the games are against Benfica in Camp Nou. We need to win this game. And against Bayern Munich in Munich. Okay, away. I don't count in Bayern Munich. I don't count in us getting any points there. Okay, let's be pessimistic. This is the way we do calculations now. We need to win against Benfica. It's just crucial. The game is in Camp Nou. Guys, revenge. We need revenge. Okay, no mercy. We need to go all in against these people. Okay, and Benfica, no mercy. No mercy. And it's our moment. It's our game. It's the most important game of the season so far. Okay, this was probably one of the most important games in the season, guys, against Dinamo Kiev. Yeah, believe me, man. If we didn't get the 3 points, our chances in the Champions League were really, really small. We're really, really small. We would have to win 4-0 against Benfica to get the goal average, and yeah, that would have been the thing. Okay, so it wasn't gonna be possible. Barcelona has no goal. We can't score goals. Therefore, how can we win 4-0 against Benfica? Anyways, guys, this is the situation right now. And I'm looking forward to what you guys have to say, guys. What do you think? Do you think that Barcelona can win against Benfica and get to the round of 16 of the Champions League? We surely need. There's one positive thing, though. One positive thing that I'd like to say. And that is this game, this game that we have to play against Benfica, most probably is going to be Xavi under the bench, okay? It's going to be Xavi. In fact, let me show you. These are the games right now. The game against Celta de Vigo, probably Xavi's not going to be there yet. Everything indicates that Xavi might be arriving the 4th of the 5th of November, literally in 2 or 3 days. The problem is that there's no time, guys. There's no time. Maybe it's going to take a bit longer, okay? So I would expect Xavi to be arriving against Espanyol after the national break. The international break, and then the crucial game 3 days later against Benfica. If Xavi can come during the international break, hopefully we have a bunch of players that stay in the club. Xavi can start teaching them, can start telling them how to play. And we can face Espanyol as practice and then play against Benfica. I surely believe we can do it, okay? I surely believe we can do it. And as I said, guys, a lot of things need to change. Do I believe in Xavi? Absolutely. Do I think Xavi is going to revolutionize the club? Absolutely. Do I believe Xavi is going to do it in 1 or 2 games? Most probably not. Okay? And I'd rather be pessimistic than super optimistic and then face reality if I have to face it. Okay? So, guys, let's be real. Let's be patient. Barca is going to come back. Barca is here to come back, but we just need a bit more patience, okay? So today was a test. I think we passed the test, by the way. 336 people right now and only 70 likes. Guys, smash that like button. It's important you guys do smash that like button. It helps me out a lot. You guys are great people, and subscribe obviously to the channel. We'll keep on growing. You guys know I'm here in Barcelona. And I try to bring you the hottest and the smartest opinions, you know. Obviously, it's my opinion. I'm a big culé, as you guys are, because you guys are Barcelona, guys. Believe me. Barcelona is not just the Barca fans from here, the people that go to the stadium. Barcelona is everyone that tunes in and watches from the TV. It's everyone that joins the Blaugrana Planet channel and interacts and watches and likes and comments and gives their opinion and talks with others. That's a real culé, guys. And that's why we have Blaugrana Planet, because it's the best way. It's the best way to connect with all the culés around the world. And one day, I am sure that one day, we can get together, guys, a bunch of us, and we can watch a game from Camp Nou, and we can do great things, guys. Just let me know when you guys are coming to Barcelona, and who knows, if I have time, we can gather up, have a beer or something, and it'll be great. So, guys, remember one thing. Real culés never give up. And now it's not the moment to give up, guys. It's a moment to be positive. It's a moment to go to sleep thinking Barcelona won and Xavi is arriving in very few days. And Barcelona is going to change. And we might have lost. We might be 9th in La Liga, 8th, 10th. I don't even know which position. But believe me, Barca will be back. So guys, thank you so much for joining. You guys are incredible people. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. And now, and as I always say, visca el Barça, visca Catalunya. And see you in the next live stream. Vamos, my people. Vamos.